The question tonight is, should the U.S. stay the course for victory in Iraq? We chose the word to tonight's resolution carefully. We did it to draw the sharpest possible lines between the two sides. We will begin with each lead speaker, beginning with the affirmative, presenting his case.
To me, staying the course means not cutting and running, not leaving prematurely, not giving the enemy your deadline. President Bush has defined victory as effectively, essentially, staying the course, staying in Iraq until we can leave behind a stable government. If we leave that mess behind, number one, we lose international credibility. Who is going to take the United States word seriously? It is not only dishonorable, but it actually breaks faith with the Iraqis who have put their faith in the United States. It also confirms the anti-American propaganda that terrorists like bin Laden and many others, or anti-Americans around the world, propose that America is just a paper tiger. It doesn't have the stamina, it doesn't have the patience, it doesn't have the commitment to finish a job. If we abandon the Iraqis before then, we're going to have a continued civil war. You're going to start or actually exacerbate the already started ethnic cleansing. That region is strategically very important to the United States, to the free world.
So what would it take to achieve the president's goal of a unified, stable, and democratic Iraq in circumstances where the country is broken up, where there's civil war, where the army and police are combatants in the civil war? Well, it would take two military steps that we are not prepared to do. First, if you want a unified and democratic Iraq, you're going to have to disband the Shiite militias, and you're going to have to disband the theocracies in the South that violate the human rights. If we wanted to end the civil war, we can't rely on the Iraqi police. They're fighters in the civil war. They're the death squads. So we would have to become the police in Baghdad and other mixed areas. That means many more troops. And of course, policemen can't sit up in their tanks and armored vehicles. They have to be out among the population. It would mean many more casualties. If we're not going to spend the resources to promote democracy, end civil war, or counter Iran's influence, and if we're not going to end the civil war, if we're not going to be the police in Baghdad, why should we be there?